What is up, guys? Rick Kakis here. Thank you so much for taking the time to join me, and today we are going to be going over all of the different legendary raid weapons from the brand new Crown of Sorrow raid to discuss the possible PvE and PvP god roles with this weapon so you guys know what roles to look for, which weapons are the best, and most notably, if it's worth going through this brand new raid. And if you decide it is, definitely check out my complete raid guide. It's gonna make your first run through a heck of a lot easier. And so, let's get started. And the first gun we're going over here is the Gahlran's Right Hand. This is a legendary kinetic auto rifle, and taking a look at the stats here, the most notable thing is that it belongs to the 360 rounds per minute auto rifle archetype. Now, if you're thinking, 360? Like, do I even have any 360s? That's probably pretty common because there is one other legendary kinetic auto rifle in the entire game that exists in this category. Now, there is actually an energy 360 auto rifle from the previous raid, the age-old Bond, that you may be more familiar with, but in any event, this is an extremely rare damage archetype. These auto rifles are going to be doing the most damage per category, but shooting the slowest. And if you like the age-old Bond, but perhaps want to use a different energy weapon, then the Gahlran's Right Hand is, well, basically your only other option. It does also get much better recoil direction, making it a little bit more easy to use than its competition, the Half-Hand D Year 1 auto rifle. But moving on from there, we have to also look at its perks. And one of the great benefits about this auto rifle is that it gains access to a bunch of the new Season of the Drifter perks. We see in its curated role, Overflow and Demolitionist, both pretty darn good perks. In the first perk category, we have a bunch of traditional perks. Something like Zen Moment is going to make it a lot more accurate, as will Tap the Trigger, as will Under Pressure, as will Dynamic Sway Reduction. So all of those perks, if you are having trouble controlling this weapon, which it does have pretty low stability as a base, you can look for a roll with that. Outlaw is also a very good perk. But in the second tier, we just have a lot of very good things. Multi-kill clip, I actually have a roll with. It's very good with this weapon. High impact reserves actually does matter when you're doing a lot more damage per shot than most other auto rifles. It also has Demolitionist, which I like quite a bit. And to be honest, Ambitious Assassin isn't terrible either. There's a lot of very good things that roll with this weapon. For PvP, rolling with high caliber rounds to increase flinch, Tap the Trigger, for example, and then another of one of the multiple good perks, is going to give you an auto rifle that competes at ranges that people are just not expecting, although it's not a very meta choice right now. PvE, however, is where this gun, I think, shines a lot more. Because of that increase in damage, you have just a lot of killing potential for each magazine. Rolling with the curated roll is fantastic. My roll with multi-kill clip is phenomenal. This gun can definitely be a very powerful option. Alright, moving on from there, we have the Calusea Noblesse Legendary Energy Scout Rifle. Looking at the stats here, this belongs to the 150 rounds per minute Scout archetype. Now, this is tied for the most damage while also shooting the slowest. And I've gotta be honest, stats-wise, this gun does not do anything special. Like, another weapon in this category is the very common cut and run energy scout, and that actually has better stats pretty much all around, so it's not looking too good. But moving on to the perks here, we do have some advantages. Firstly, the curated roll is actually pretty darn good, with fourth times the charm and full auto trigger system, letting you absolutely lay into higher power PvE enemies that you're gonna need to shoot quite a bit, including bosses. That would be a pretty good roll for a primary to take down a boss. And looking at the rest of the perks here, we do have, yet again, the presence of the very powerful Season of the Drifter perks. Substance is here, as well as Multi-Kill Clip. We do also have Disruption Break, which started out as a perk for the Escalation SMG that's made its way onto a few different weapons in Season of Opulence. We also have some old classics. Zen Moment is decent. Outlaw is pretty good with a powerful scout. Rampage is always good, and so is Dragonfly, especially with a scout. The problem with this weapon is that scout rifles are just not doing very well in either PvP or PvE. Now, if you like these weapons already, there is some definite PvE value, I think, to be had here. PvP-wise, I just can't see a role that's really going to come together. Maybe, like, Outlaw Rampage could be decent. Outlaw Dragonfly. But Outlaw Dragonfly is also great in PvE. In PvE, you have a lot more options in terms of Outlaw or Sustenance or even Disruption Break or even Zen Moment would all be decent with Multi-Kill Clip, Rampage, or Dragonfly. In fact, the curator role would also be good, I think, kind of in either PvP or PvE. But again, it's not really about the role, it's about the gun type. The fact that it's a scout rifle, that's holding it down. And in fact, the few scout rifles that have seen some success are not a part of this damage archetype as well. So kind of double whammy in the negatives. But it is time to move on from there to a very good weapon, the Emperor's Courtesy Legendary Energy Shotgun. Now, taking a look at the stats here, firstly, ignore the impact, that's a little bit glitched, but it still does belong to the 80 rounds per minute shotgun archetype. So, what other weapons belong here? Well, notably, the Parcel of Stardust Gambit Shotgun, which some people actually do really like that in PvP. Now, this is in the energy category, and stats-wise, it's better than the Parcel of Stardust in pretty much every single category. It has better starting range, better starting stability, better starting handling, better starting reload speed. It's just the upgraded version of the Parcel. If you like the Parcel, you gotta get yourself the Emperor's Courtesy. It's just better. Moving on to the perks, we kind of see that as well. Now, PvP-wise, you can get some disgusting rolls. You can get full choke and accurized rounds, and quick draw is phenomenal on shotguns, or also snapshot sights, some people really do like, and then combine that with slide shot or opening shot for a really powerful roll. I have the bungee roll Mindbender's Ambition that has opening shot. I think that's a super overlooked perk. It's incredibly powerful, and you can absolutely like map people with that perk. And even if it rolls with something like Rampage or even Swashbuckler, that's decent in PvP as well. So very powerful rolls present here. PvE is the exact same thing. The bungee roll of Grave Robber plus 1-2 punch, which hitting an enemy with every pellet in a shot increases melee damage for a short duration. I actually was lucky enough to get it, and it is very powerful and quite the wombo combo. If you do roll it with Grave Robber and Swashbuckler, that's a wombo combo as well. In fact, in PvP, 1-2 punch lets you shoot and then melee kill a guardian in their super, which is very powerful. And again, PvE-wise, so many different options here. Field prep is often overlooked, but actually quite good. Quick draw would also be decent in PvE, as well as Grave Robber. Swashbuckler is phenomenal. Surrounded is one of the best PvE perks out there, especially because you can get the Surrounded Spec mod that makes it even more powerful. Rampage, as always, is fantastic. A lot of really powerful stuff going on here. At the end of the day, the Emperor's Courtesy is going to be one of the most desirable weapons from this new raid, and it's definitely worth going after. But it is time to move on to the last legendary weapon you can get from this raid, and that is the Bane of Sorrow Legendary Machine Gun. Now, looking at the stats here, just like the new Menagerie Machine Gun, this belongs to a whole new damage archetype that didn't exist before Season of Opulence, the 360 rounds per minute archetype. So kind of like the Gahlran's right hand we looked at earlier, but doing a lot more damage. Now, compared to its menagerie counterpart, it has less starting stability, but better handling, reload speed, and magazine size as well. Looking at the perks here, it has the possibility to get the Fatebringer God roll with Outlaw and Dragonfly. Now, Dragonfly is usually pretty good on hand cannons and scout rifles, but in the presence of an extremely high damage per shot machine gun, it's gonna be pretty darn good there as well. That's a very powerful option. Looking at the rest of the perks, there's, again, powerful options out there. Tap the trigger if you do need help with that stability under pressure as well to calm down the stability. But Feeding Frenzy is great, especially in PvE. And in the final tier of perks, we have Demolitionist, which is very good, Kill Clip, which can be very powerful, Rampage, always good, and even High Impact Reserves. And again, the damage per shot here is very, very high. High Impact Reserves will definitely matter. So for PvP, something like Under Pressure or Tap the Trigger and Rampage could be very, very powerful. And in PvE, well, you know, basically anything with Kill Clip, Rampage, or even Demolitionist, and especially if you do get that bungee roll, that's gonna be very good as well. It is exciting that we're finally getting machine guns of different archetypes. And so guys, that is it for our look at all of the different legendary Crown of Sorrow weapons you can get. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it informative. If you did, please remember to help me out by simply rating and especially sharing this video. If you guys want to see more Destiny 2 content similar to this, don't be afraid to slap that subscribe button. If you guys want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter at @RickKakis. That's linked in the description down below. Again, hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a good day.